guys, welcome back to the channel. So today we are going to see how to create or how to use Translator plugin in Flutter, which will help you translate your app over 100 languages. So here now you can see this is a very basic Flutter project, just simple scaffold, and here we have added Translator. So let's get started. So now we are going to create some variables. This is the value which will indicate what language we are currently using. So currently we are going to use English, which has a code of EN. I will show you the website where all the codes are shared. So this is basic message. And now we are creating a translator instance. After that we are going to create our UI. In app bar we are going to just show our screen or our string. The column where we'll put our widgets. We use center to keep our widgets in center. Now let's fix main axis alignment. Now we will add children to it. First we are going to add a text field. We will add some decoration. Okay, so now we are going to use onChange function. Here we are just going to set state where string equals to val.toString, and we will set chosen value to English because input will be obviously in English. Now we are going to use drop down button to change to select language. This will be of data type string. Here you can add multiple languages. I'm just going to add a few of those. These are English, Marathi, Malayalam and Hindi. Drop down menu item. This to list. Now here we are going to use onChanged function. The function will be async because we will be translating all the string values which are to be used. The from which language we are going to translate, and also provide to which language we are going to translate. Now once that is done, we are going to set our states, or we are going to allocate this temporary values to our main variables. Now here we have to use trans.txt. There are many variables under it. You can check the values for each of them. And also we have to change chosen value now. That is done, we are going to add one more variable, one more widget. That will be just a simple text displaying a string value. here we have to just change its font style, or I can say text font size to 20. Here it is already suggesting to use const because of all this, because of this linter, Flutter lint dependency. So now once you run this, you will get the desired output. So let me just close it to show you the different language codes which are available in this plugin. So here you can see these are all language codes which you can use in your Flutter plugin app, in your Flutter app using Translator plugin. Okay, thank you guys. If you found this video useful, leave a like and subscribe for more amazing content. Thank you.